just pulled out.
You take it from here. Tommy? Hey, well, let's go, man. Let's go. Come on. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Right on time. Tommy?
What's going on, friend?
A hijacking, friend.
Get out of the cab.
Hey, man, you can take the rig if you want it, but don't shoot me. I got...
No, thanks.
What's wrong with it?
Nothing. I'm just not thirsty, that's all.
Oh, come on, Andy. In this heat, you're not thirsty. It's a drink. Don't make anything out of that.
It would taste a bit like charity.
Oh, man. Too much.
By the way, how's Todd?
Same as any 8-year-old born with a cyanotic heart.
What I meant. What did the doctors have to say about him?
The Todd's unique. He's cyanotic. He has dextrocardia.
Dextrocardia. That means the heart's on the wrong side, isn't it? I knew a guy like that once. He was okay. They didn't operate on him. They just left him alone.
Well, then he didn't have the complications Todd has. He has to be operated on, but have to wait till he's full grown, maybe another 7 or 8 years.
It's a lot of years. A lot of treatment. A lot of money.
Attention, units in vicinity of Highway 2 and Canyon Road. I have Ludlow 9 in pursuit of a stolen gasoline tanker southbound on Highway 2 and requesting assistance. Report positions.
Control, this is Ludlow 5. We're 6 blocks west of Highway 2. We'll assist. Over.
Roger, Ludlow 5. Code 3.
Taking it easy. Breakthrough on track 3. See if you can locate Ludlow 9's exact position.
Ludlow 5 to Ludlow 9. What's your exact position? Over.
Highway 2, approaching intersection 95.
I read you. We'll try to meet you on 95. We're headed there now. We'll try to intercept you at the dead end.
Shoot at 100 octane bomb.
Thank you. punk. Great work, Andy.
Yeah, I'm not so sure I agree.
Something bugging you, Mike?
Yeah, your heroics and my mortality.
Just earning my wages, partner.
Look, Andy, you're paid to be a cop, not a kamikaze.
If the heat's too hot, stay out of the kitchen. Move it, Danko.
Now, a year and a half ago, there would be no way you could convince me that anyone would be hijacking gasoline.
Well, think about it. A year and a half ago, we paid 28 cents a gallon. Now it's up to 62 cents a gallon. Now, that tanker carried 7,000 gallons. Figure it out.
Not a bad day's pay. Especially if you consider there's no withholding tax. Mm. Working out there in the country, away from the city and all the smog.
Hey, work it out with Andy?
No, I didn't get a chance. He got a phone call and split right after we booked Putnam.
His son?
I don't know. Now, I still don't understand why you're so hacked at Andy.
Because I don't dig people playing Code 3 roulette with my life. The last few days, he's been coming on like he was an also-ran in a demolition derby. If he wasn't having problems at home, I'd ask Riker for a new partner.
Go ahead and ask. I've been known to grant requests before. Tell me, Officer Danko, why should I give you a new partner?
Look, just forget it, will you, Lieutenant?
Police lieutenants and elephants never forget.
It's just the day has been such a bummer.
A bad day, I can understand. What I don't understand is why are you so upset about being partnered with a cop like Andy Page?
Look, I like Andy. I respect Andy, but lately he's been coming on like he's super cop.
He is super cop. He got the Medal of Valor twice in the last 5 years.
Well, I suggest he back off or he's gonna get the next one posthumously.
Let me tell you something. When he was a rookie, I broke him in. I know what he's capable of. I know what kind of values he has. I don't know why you're so all-fired and indignant. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll give you your request. You'll have a new partner. Not because I think you know what you're talking about. I won't have two men riding together when one of them feels the way you do. Right or wrong, they're just no good for each other.
That leaves Patriot without partners, huh?
All right, Owens, until further notice, you are now partnered with Andy Page. You can ride with Webster.
Lieutenant, that's not what I wanted. Now, Chris is too green to ride with a cop like Andy Page.
Danko, you're too far out on a limb. If you can say something that will show me that Page is a threat to any man he works with, all right, say it and prove it. If not, you're going to have to back off. You cannot soil a man's reputation unless you're willing to stand up and be counted.
Come on, Lieutenant. No one was trying to soil anyone's reputation. Just worried about Chris, that's all.
Hey, now, don't worry about Chris.
Don't worry about Chris.
Hey, how's about a beer, huh? And I'm springing.
Okay, you spring for the beer, and I'll spring for a little advice. Look, Chris, you don't know what you're getting yourself into.
I know. I'm the new kid on the block. But Mike, I've got to learn by making my own mistakes.
This mistake may cost you more than you're willing to pay.
At the academy, you learn from your mistakes. In the field, you die from them.
I know what you're trying to do, both of you. And I appreciate it, but...
You want to think for yourself?
You got it. I'm going to ride with Andy. I'm going to learn what he can teach me. And I plan on being around a long time to use it. Fair?
Of course, fair. Come on.
Not serious, it's just the sniffles.
Thank God. I was afraid it was another infection.
Well, you're right to bring him in, Laura.
Can't afford to, can't afford not to. Where do we take him the next time he needs help?
Right here.
Not sure we can do that, Jill. The hospital sent us one of those pay-up we'll see in court letters.
Well, Todd has to have access to a cardiologist at all times. Look. I'll talk to the hospital administrator. I'll see what I can do, okay?
Thanks. Tell him I'm expecting a windfall. Tell him enough money to pay off everything.
Hey, look who I found coming out of the examination. Anybody claim this little guy?
Oh, we all do.
Dr. Gore says I'm gonna be all right.
See what I tell you. Now you can get back to school and see your friends, huh?
What grade are you gonna be in, Tom? About third?
Well, they're not so sure what grade I'm in. I'm not in school enough to have a grade.
Well, it's time for me to get to work at the garage.
Sure, you're wishing you'd come home and be with us.
So do I, son, so do I. Thanks for talking to your boss, Jill.
Oh, by the way, Andy, something came up at the precinct after you left.
Could we talk?
Can it wait, Mike? I might miss my bus.
Yeah. Bye. I'll see you later.
How come he doesn't have medical insurance? I thought it was mandatory.
Well, it is now. Should have been when Andy joined the force 11 years ago, but it wasn't. Rookies didn't make that much money then. Tax, life insurance didn't leave a heck of a lot to live on.
Joey opted not to have the medical insurance.
They thought they wouldn't need it. Decided to go for a house instead. Now that's mortgage to the hilt.
Boy, you wonder how they've made it since Todd came along.
Couldn't have been easy. It's going to be impossible now. I don't know how he's going to make it.
Can you come home early tonight, Dad?
I'll try, son.
Andy, upstairs, you said something about a windfall.
Oh, that. Well, I told Jill that to help get one more bill collector off our back.
Then it isn't true.
Well, sure it's true. Todd's all right. He's out of the hospital. That's a big windfall, right, buddy?
Andy, this came this morning. With Todd in here, I didn't want to show it to you. It's from the bank. We're 6 months behind on the house payments, and they're giving us 30 days to catch up.
Stop worrying. Who knows? Maybe we'll have one real big windfall, huh?
Andy, this is me you're talking to, not Jill. Where would we get that kind of money?
It can happen. A lot of things can happen.
Hey, we'll make out. Just don't think of anything foolish, okay? Please.
Hey, I love you. I love you both more than anything else in the world. I'll see you tonight.
What's wrong, Mom?
Nothing, baby. Everything's fine. Just fine.
All right, settle down. Come on, knock it off. Take your seats, please. Another gasoline tanker was hijacked early this morning. This does not make the oil companies happy, and they have so informed headquarters. Yesterday, Officer Page collared a suspect. Man's name is Stoney Putnam. He is expected to be out on bail this morning immediately following arraignment. All of this is by way of saying that we will make the oil companies and headquarters very happy by making this hijack company very unhappy and hopefully extinct. Keep your eyes open. I want you to report any and all leads directly to me. Are there any questions? Effective immediately, Page and Owens are assigned to Ludlow 5, Webster and Danko, Ludlow 9. Check your pin maps, hit the street, dismissed.
Andy, that's what I tried to tell you at the hospital.
You asked to be switched?
No, I was mouthing off about you playing John Wayne and Riker overheard me. Look, Andy, I'm sorry I didn't...
I'm all through, huh? Trying to tell me your old fist is all through with the big leagues. You know something? Baseball writers are always knocking guys like me because my arm goes sore, right? I want to tell you something. I wish I could tell them I'm making more money than I ever dreamed about before.
It's like owning your own World Series, huh?
And with three other stations working, the gate's going to get nothing but bigger. How many gallons we get this morning?
8,400, all Wethel, at 62.9 per.
Not bad. Are you crazy showing up here?
Hey, man, my chick posted bail. She said you wanted to see me.
Yeah, fine, but not in broad daylight.
And nobody is watching me. I spent the last hour checking that out.
Like you made sure yesterday, huh?
I got busted. Because you didn't put that driver to sleep long enough, you dig. All of a sudden, I'm staring into the face of some flipped-out cop named Page who's blockading the road like it was some kind of Fort Knox.
Andy Page?
What do you know?
I know of him. He moonlights at Nick's garage. He's a grease monkey.
A cop who moonlights? How come?
I don't know, something about doctor bills. Nick says that something's wrong with his kid or something.
Wonder if Page would like to earn a little more money than Nick pays him for moonlighting.
I don't think you can buy him. I mean, they say he has a rep. All cop.
Tommy, when you got a need for money, you could be a hack. When am I going to teach you that? Let's say we find out.
You know, Andy, you don't realize how much weight your name carries with the guys down at the Academy. You're one of the heroes they hold up to us.
Maybe the Academy should have talked to that Arthur fella who said, show me a hero and I'll write you a tragedy.
What about procedure, partner?
Well, my procedure's real simple. Find somebody who's busting the law, bust them. You nervous riding with me?
Should I be?
No. I'll see that you're protected.
Attention, all units, vicinity of Elm and Dwyer. I have a 211 in progress at John's Market on Elm and Dell Street.
This is Ludlow 5, in vicinity and rolling.
Control, Roger. Ludlow 5, handle code 3.
Crush your legs.
Are you Andy Page?
Yeah, what can I do for you?
Nothing mechanical, but a lot as a cop. A friend tells me you're hurting for money.
Isn't everybody these days?
Not me. How bad are you hurting?
How bad are you hurting?
Suppose I was in the market for the right kind of painkiller.
Suppose I had it.
Then you'd probably pick up 500 every time you made a simple radio call to headquarters.
What kind of call?
The kind that keeps certain of their vehicles out of the area that mine are in when they do their thing.
What's their thing?
Nothing violent.
I'll need time to think. Let me sleep on it.
Listen, Andy. Just dial this phone number and leave a message for her. And Andy, that money really could kill a lot of your pain. Why don't you think about that, okay? Take it easy.
You should have seen Andy. Two freaked out hypes shooting at us, right? And he never even drew his gun.
He didn't draw his gun when he busted Stoney Putnam either.
Question is, what's he trying to prove?
Especially now when he's almost out of the woods.
What do you mean?
Well, Andy said he was expecting a big enough windfall to be able to pay off all his hospital bills.
What kind of a windfall?
An inheritance?
No, that's impossible. He's got no living relative.
Well, he probably floated alone.
He told me he had a zero credit rating.
What he probably did was put you on. I mean, with his kind of bills, he's got to be good at it by now. Keep the collectors hopeful.
I hate to say it, but you don't suppose Andy could be doing anything illegal, do you?
No way.
I'm sorry.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Let's think about it. Could he be on the take?
No.
No, I agree with Chris. Andy needs more money than any graft a patrol cop can pick up on the street.
Besides, that wouldn't explain his heroics.
Sweetheart, could you get the cheese?
Sure. No, but I know what would.
So do I.
Andy doesn't have any medical insurance, but he does have a $50,000 life insurance policy. Double indemnity. That's 100 big ones.
Yeah. The policy is only part of it. If he gets killed in the line of duty, his family collects full pension.
He's worth more to his family dead than he is alive. All he's got to do is get himself killed. On the job suicide.
So much for routine. Now we come to a subject that has become a real sore spot at headquarters lately, hijacking. We had another one late last night in which the driver was fatally shot. In the meantime, Stoney Putnam has skipped bail. That's why we have an APB out on him. We want this man badly. So far, we've only had one break. That's three stolen tankers that showed up empty in an abandoned warehouse. That makes me think that the gasoline is being sold locally. Detective teams are checking every gas station in town, and I don't have to tell you there are hundreds. All right, that's it. I want to see Page and Owens in my office immediately. Check your pin maps, hit the street, dismissed.
What's he want to see us about?
What's up, Lieutenant?
My blood pressure. 2 days ago, Officer Danko was concerned about you playing super cop. Now, this planted a seed in my mind. I decided to look into it and see if he's right or wrong, and he is right. Now, my information comes from interrogating a couple of addicts you busted for ripping off a market. According to them, Officer Page, you never drew your service revolver.
I collared him, didn't I?
I'm not talking about results. I am talking about the means through which they are achieved. If for some religious reason or moral reason you find yourself incapable of returning a man's fire, I can respect that, but I cannot condone it.
That's not the reason, Lieutenant.
Then I would like to know what was.
It's Todd.
I see.
Pressure's been building up lately. Every time a sneeze comes Todd's way, me and Laura panic. Figure that might be it for him. One little bug inside his bloodstream could be fatal. 8 years of that kind of agony takes its toll, scrambles a man's thinking.
That I can also respect, but I cannot send officers out on the street who do not think straight.
That's past tense. I got it all back together.
How do I know that?
Because I'm telling you.
No more super cop? This is the bottom line, Andy. Any more of these destructive heroics, I'm putting you on suspension. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Owens, I'm not supposed to obtain information from a couple of hoods who've been collared on the street, you know. Now, your report should have included that Officer Page did not draw his service revolver when he went after these two suspects.
Yes, sir.
Owens, I'm giving you a direct order. If he pulls any more of this nonsense, you report it to me immediately. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
Hit the street.
Sure you don't want to drive?
No, no, you're doing fine. Besides, I wouldn't want the temptation if that radio came out with a code 3.
Joe mentioned you were expecting a windfall.
Oh, that, yeah, yeah. Laura's uncle left her a piece of ground.
Great.
Yeah, that property's gonna get us out of hock. For the next 7 or 8 years, maybe. Pay for Todd's medical treatment, and then his surgery when he's finally old enough. Pull over here to that phone, will you? It's time to call in and check with Todd. Message for Earl.
I got your message. Ready to start work?
The sooner the better.
Good, I like eager beavers.
I got just one question for you. How do you know I'm not setting you up for a bust?
Oh, Andy, I ran a credit check. You're so deep in debt, a bulldozer couldn't dig you out.
Lots of cops are in debt.
Yeah, but they don't have a sick kid with an expensive heart problem.
Since we know all about me, let's talk about you.
I deal in gasoline. That's all you need to know.
Gasoline, huh? Like in hijacking tankers?
Does that bother you, Andy?
Nothing bothers me except doctor bills. As long as nobody gets hurt. When do I start cashing in?
I'll let you know.
Soon?
Real soon. Don't get involved in any good books. Take it easy.
How you feeling, son?
Okay. I was dreaming.
You were? What were you dreaming about?
Fun things. Like, forget it's only a dream.
Well, dreams have a way of coming true. Not the asleep kind, but the awake kind.
I wish you didn't have to work so hard so I could be more at home with me and Mom.
Okay, can you keep a secret?
Sure.
Pretty soon, there might be a whole bunch of money.
Wow. Did you hear that, Mom?
I heard. Honey, you better get some sleep.
Daddy?
Yeah.
I love you.
Sleep.
Wish I had been.
Is there something wrong, honey?
You tell me.
Andy, I've got to know about that money.
It's a loan.
Who from?
Somebody you don't know.
Andy, don't insult my intelligence.
And stop talking to me like I'm some kind of suspect.
Maybe you are.
What's that supposed to mean?
Andy, are you going on the take?
No.
Then where's the money gonna come from?
Alone.
Don't, Andy, not with me.
I said alone.
You want me to trust you, Andy, but you make it hard. You make it very hard.
Hi. Ready to start paying off some of those doctor bills?
I told you I was.
Dial this phone number at 10 a.m. today for instructions. Paige.
Yeah?
Any double cross and your kid's gonna be sicker than you ever thought possible.
Don't sweat it. We're both in the same bag now.
Fine.
Hello?
It's me.
Hi. Are you all right? Did you forget something?
No, I just wanted to talk to you. I wish I were there to hold you. To make you understand. To see in your eyes that you do.
Andy, what's the matter? What's going on? Andy, look, why don't you come on back home now, please?
I can't. I love you, Laura. I love you both more than life itself.
Andy? Page.
Webster Tango with me.
What about roll call?
Alder's got it. He knows about this. Come on now. We got a lead on Stoney Putman.
Where are you going?
Work.
I won't be here when you get back. My old man's due home from a selling trip, and I'd better be there.
Oh, yeah? Well, why don't you get him a welcome home present? Put my name on the card.
Police, open up! Raise it! Drop it. Over against the wall. Move it.
How did you guys know I was here, huh?
A friendly private investigator was hired by this lady's husband to keep an eye on her while he was out of town.
Some husband doesn't even trust me.
What time you got, kid? 2 minutes to 10. Time to check the home front.
Thank you.
right on time.
What are my instructions?
In exactly 30 minutes, put in a radio call that'll clear every cop out of the Junction Highway, Burroughs Road area.
I know the gas station.
Forget that. Just make sure my teammates have total privacy.
When do I get my money?
After you earn it. Where's Stoney?
He didn't show. I phoned his motel, no answer.
The bum probably got mixed up with the chick and forgot what day it is.
He could be in trouble.
That's his problem.
Well, maybe we ought to cancel out, huh?
No rain checks. In this business, you've got to make it when you can. Come on, hey, we got time for a fast cup of coffee. Take it easy.
Oh, damn.
What's the matter?
I've been thinking that rear tire there's been low on air. Do you mind checking it?
No.
Thanks.
Owner on premises.
Can't make 40
feet.
That's terrible.
Tire's fine.
Okay, how about cruising the Burro Canyons road area? That's where a lot of those hijackings have been coming down.
You're the boss. I'll advise control.
Let low 5 to control.
Over.
Let low 5 to control. Over. Control, this is Ludlow 5. Hey, the radio's gone out on us.
You're kidding.
We better drive back in and get it checked.
We got time. Later.
But what if someone needs to raise us?
Hey!
You're too young for ulcers. Stop worrying.
Come on, Andy. Without a radio, we're out of touch. I think we better drive back in.
I said later. And like you said, I'm running this black and white.
I told you, there's no top man. I'm strictly a loner.
You're strictly a liar.
God is my witness.
Stop name dropping. I want to know who's running that gasoline operation.
I gotta go to the bathroom.
You talk to me, Putnam. I want one name. That's all I need.
There is no name. Look, you gave me my rights. You said I didn't have to say nothing.
You don't have to. I thought you might like to. It'll make you feel better with all this guilt you're feeling. I told you, do not disturb.
Sorry. Jill Danko and Andy Page's wife are in your office. They say it's an emergency. I don't know nothing about Page either.
Entertain him. What's the emergency, ladies?
Lieutenant, now, we know how you feel about wives interfering,
Mrs. Danko, if this is an emergency, I suggest you get to the point.
We think that Andy's going to try and get himself killed today. The way he's been acting, the things he's been saying, they all point to it.
He's desperate for money, Lieutenant, and it's available to him through his insurance policy and his pension.
Mrs. Riker, patch me through to Ludlow 5 right away. How long you been out of contact? Keep trying. We have a communications gap. I'm gonna plug it up right now. Pay close attention to me, Putnam, because I'm only gonna say this once. A gasoline driver has already been killed. Andy Page is either dead or he's on the verge. You know something about Page and you're not telling me. Either you start spilling your guts in the next 5 seconds, or I'm gonna book you on suspicion of murder.
Look, Lieutenant, all I know about Andy Page is that he's the cop that busted me.
Let me put it to you this way. Page is a close friend of mine. If he turns up dead, do you know what I'm gonna do?
Okay. Look, I didn't kill the driver, okay? Tom Harper did.
Now, what about Page?
Well, Fisher, the guy I work for offered Page money to keep the cops out of the area while we pulled off jobs.
Did Page take that money?
No, the deal started today.
When and where?
Junction Highway and Burroughs Road.
This is Lieutenant Riker. I got a top priority code 3. I want a car and a driver.
Andy, what's going on?
I told you I had to check out something.
Here?
Here. I don't want to be seen.
Well, shouldn't I know what's going on?
I got an anonymous tip on the hijackers.
Orders were to report all leads to Riker.
Tell Riker and he'll turn it over to those credit-grabbing detectives.
Hey, you're not planning on playing super cop with this one.
I'm just checking things out and nailing them down. Then I'll tell Riker. You stay here.
I'm coming with you.
I'd hate to put that in the form of an order, rookie.
I'd hate to have you do it.
Well, I'm doing it. Stay put.
Hiya, Pop.
What do you say?
Got a load of carburetor juice for you.
Oh, I could use it.
I got gas, oil, water, and air. What's your pleasure?
Hey, what are you doing?
Ludlow 5 to control. Come in, please.
I never was very good at following instructions, even from people I like, and you gotta know what I think of you.
I got the message. You want more money paid, you got it.
You haven't got the kind of money I need. There's only one way out. Pass me.
I know a shakedown when I see it, Paige. What's coming off? You want a better deal? You got it.
No deal.
Then what are you standing in the way for?
I told you. There's only one way out. Pass me. You're gonna have to kill me. You hear that? Kill me! This one's dead. You know, you could have got yourself killed. You look like some kind of super cop coming over that car, rookie.
I had a good teacher.
Thank you.
Honey, it's all right. Todd's fine. Don't worry.
Well, thank you for coming down, Mrs. Page. Would you care to join us in my office?
Lieutenant, maybe you can tell me why I'm here.
I have before me 2.5 weeks of daily reports. I see nothing to indicate any unnecessary heroics or to suggest that Officer Page has been playing super cop. Would you care to verify that, Officer Owens?
Yes.
Well, now that you've cleared that up, Lieutenant, would you mind telling me why you dragged Laura down here to hear that?
She wasn't dragged, Officer Page. She was invited. I felt that it was important for her to know that she has nothing to worry about anymore when she says goodbye to you in the morning. No more than any other policeman's wife, and God knows they have enough already.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
Yeah, thanks, Lieutenant. I do appreciate it. I've been trying to tell her 100 different ways. No more super cop. No more dumb moves.
We'll get by, somehow.
Somehow might include a very grateful oil company. One of their representatives has been nosing around here, asking questions about the Page family and their financial problems. And there's talk about a trust fund to meet some medical bills.
Lieutenant, are you serious?
Absolutely, Mrs. Page. Your husband saved them an awful lot of money.
Yeah, but there's just one hitch, Lieutenant. An officer can't accept rewards.
You won't have to. The talk is that this trust fund will be made out to Master Todd Page. Owens, I think you asked a very intelligent question. You said, what am I doing here? Come on, I'm going to buy you some lunch. I'm feeling good.